Robby Ameen, the drummer on this project, I had worked with him before, and he liked the way that I made his drum sound, and he approached me and informed me about what this was.
Yeah, I brought Dave Kowalski in as engineer. He actually worked on my last solo record, and I had worked with him in the past on other projects. And the other great thing and necessary thing about him is that he can do... he does Latin music, he does jazz, he does funk, rock, etc.
Ready to rip!
Coincidentally, I was a user of the products that we're doing this for, which is TuneTrack, and I knew we were in for a little bit of meticulous sampling at every particular level of the drums and the cymbals and all the assorted percussion instruments that Richie Flores also was bringing to the project.
As I was approached by TuneTrack, they asked me to recommend a percussionist that I, you know, somebody that I'd worked with a lot, and Richie Flores came to mind immediately because he's probably the percussionist I've worked with the most since I was 21.
Robby see me for the first time. He went to Puerto Rico, and I was 9 years old, and he saw me playing with like jazz session in Puerto Rico. And he was like impressed, you know, like, oh my God, this little kid playing this kind of music at this age. And that was the first time that we met.
Even if I couldn't stand him, I would have recommended him for this project because he's such an incredible percussionist. But it just so happens I love him too. Here he is.
Speak of the devil.
All right. Oye, estoy en la entrevista, ¿qué pasó?
That's funny. Well, we recorded at Sear Sound, and behind me you can see this beautiful 80 series Neve console, which most engineers will tell you is a godsend to have when you're recording.
Great mic collection, great board, Neve board, and great sounding room. So, yeah, it was nice to be here.
What we recorded with Richie is the standard set for Latin percussion, which are congas, timbales, cowbells, woodblocks, and all of the smaller hand percussion as well. So you won't be wanting for anything.
Doing it with percussion kind of snowballs into it's a big deal because percussion is such a huge part. I mean, it's the basis of, you know, Afro-Cuban music. So obviously it's something that we're doing together, but also there's so much in the percussion that it becomes almost two projects that are kind of parallel and complement each other.
So with these two libraries, you could have all of the basic percussion and drum sounds for jazz and Latin music at your fingertips.
For this recording, I used two completely different drum sets, and then there were some variations of snare drums and a couple of different sets of cowbells too.
On Robby's kit, he uses a cowbell on a foot pedal, a cowbell in the middle, and a timbale off to the side.
Yeah, the cowbells also are a big part of this music on the drums. I use them almost as often, as much as cymbals and hi-hat in this music, because that's what you're riding on a lot of the time too. So, yeah, this is a more cowbell project.
That was a great thing.
This is something out of the ordinary drum library.
I think the idea of having this is gonna let people that already know and love this music, that wanna be able to use it in what they're doing, and people that may not have been exposed to it and say, oh yeah, wait, that groove could really be interesting, and it's kind of, you know, opening my mind up a little bit.
This is for everybody, you know, for rock, you know, for hip hop, real authentic sound. And I think I want to use that too. It's going to be for me too.
To like finalize, I sum up everything. It's been really a fun process, both doing the sounds and the grooves. So I'm really curious and looking forward to hearing it when it's all done and being able to mess with it, you know, on a little computer and do stuff with it.